In this tutorial video, I'm going to show you how you can use the Ventoy auto install plugin to install Windows 10 or 11 and how to include an auto unattend answer file in the installation. So this video is going to serve as a tutorial video for method 3 on my unattended Winstall GitHub project. And if you're unfamiliar with that, I basically created this GitHub project here where I made some pre-made unattended answer files that you can use during the Windows 10 and 11 setup process to automatically debloat and customize Windows before you even get to the desktop. So if you're unfamiliar with that, I'll link it down in the description below as well as the other videos I created on the project. But to get started with method 3, I'm going to show you step by step what you need to do to install Windows using the answer file with the Ventoy auto install plugin. So first off, we're going to download the preferred auto unattended XML file. So if you scroll down on this README page here, you're going to get to the section where you can choose one of the following versions. Now, at the time of this recording, I've got three versions. I've got the IoT LTAC-like version, I've got the standard version, and I've got the core version. I might release some more versions in the future, so always check back on this GitHub page to see if there's any changes or updates to these files. But we need to choose one of these versions, and you can see the changes between all of them just by reading the description here. But I just recently added the core version, which basically disables Windows Defender. So to download it, I'm just going to click on the core button here. That's going to take me to the core version of the file, and then to download it, you can just click on this button here to download the raw file, and it's going to download the autounattend.xml file. Another way to do this is to just click on the raw button here, which will show it in your browser. And from here, you can just right click anywhere, then select save as, then just choose a save location. In my case, it's going to be the desktop, and then you can just save that file. Now, it already exists because I just showed you how to download it using the download button on GitHub. So that's why I'm prompted to replace it. And in this case, I'm just going to say yes. And then you can see it's also downloaded the XML file. So once you've downloaded the preferred version of your file and saved it to your computer, you can go to the next step, and that is to download the Windows 10 or Windows 11 ISO file. In this case, I'll use Windows 11, so I'm just going to click on that to open it in a new tab. And then to download the ISO file, you can just select the multi-edition ISO file, then click on download now. Select your preferred language. I always choose English US, then click on confirm, and then you'll get a download link. And if you click on that, it'll start downloading the Windows 11 ISO file. I've got plenty of guides on my channel showing you how to download these files, and I also have another step-by-step guide showing you how you can use method 2 and method 1 as outlined here on the GitHub page. And you can also have a look at that video tutorial right there if there's anything unclear about downloading the Windows ISO file, because in that video I do show you how to download both Windows 10 and Windows 11. So once you're done with step 2 and you've got the Windows 10 or Windows 11 ISO file, then you can download and install Ventoy. So I'm just going to hold down Control and then click on Ventoy, and it's going to open it in a new tab. Then to download it, you can just go to the Releases tab here on the right, click on that, and then scroll down. And then you want to download the latest Windows Ventoy zip release here. If you click on that, it's going to download a zip file. Then I'll just click on the folder so I can open it in the downloads folder. And in my case, it is saved on the desktop. So there I have the auto unattended XML file I downloaded earlier, as well as the Windows 11 ISO file. So we're just going to ignore those for now. With regards to the Ventoy zip file, you can just right click on it, and then you can click on extract all. You can leave it in the same directory, then just click on extract, and it'll open the new Ventoy folder. You can go ahead and double click on that to open it, and then you're going to find all of these files inside. So what you need to do now is you need to plug in your USB flash drive, the one that you're going to be using to install Windows. And then once you've done that, you can double click on this Ventoy to disk file here, and it's going to open the Ventoy application. So the first thing you need to have a look at here is that you do detect your USB flash disk and that it needs to be at least 8 gigs in size. This one's a 32 gig, so there's plenty of space. If you don't see your USB flash drive here, then you can also click on this refresh button and it should detect it. But once it's detected here in the Ventoy application, you can just click on install. You'll be prompted that the data on it will be lost. So if there's anything saved on this USB flash drive of yours, that's important. You need to go ahead and copy it to a different directory or make a backup of it on another device or on your computer, because this USB flash drive will be formatted now and the data on it will be lost. So before you can continue, you need to type yes in all caps, then click on OK. Once again, you'll see this warning that it's going to be formatted and you'll lose your data. If you're sure you want to continue, then you can click on yes. And another check will ask you If you're sure that you want to go ahead and format the drive because the data will be lost, you can just click on Yes again to continue, and that's going to install Ventoy to the USB flash drive. Once it's done, you'll see that it's been successfully installed. Then you can go ahead and click on OK and then just exit out of Ventoy. For now, you can leave this Ventoy folder open. You don't have to close it yet, but you can open a new File Explorer window, and I'm going to do that by holding down Shift and then just clicking on the File Explorer tab there, which will open this PC on my computer. But you basically need to navigate to this PC so you can get to your Ventoy USB flash drive. As you can see, it's labeled Ventoy, so I'm going to go ahead and double click on that. And now if we go back and have a look at our instructions here, we need to create a folder structure. And at the time of this recording, this isn't 100% accurate. I'm going to update it when I upload this video tutorial. But basically, we need to create the following folders, which is going to be ISO. And then inside of that folder is going to be a Windows folder. And then we need to also create a templates folder. And they should be at the root of the drive. I'm going to go ahead and do step 4 and show you what that looks like. So if you go over to the Ventoy flash drive here, you can right click and then make a new folder. We're going to call that ISO. Then we're going to right click again, create another folder, and we're going to name that templates. Then we're going to go into the ISO folder and we're going to create a new folder again. And we're going to call this Windows. And then we're going to open this Windows folder. And then we're going to copy the Windows ISO file that we downloaded earlier into this Windows directory. So I have it saved on my desktop, so I'll just navigate to that. So I'm just going to right click on this ISO file, then click on copy, and then I'm going to paste it into the Windows folder that's on my Ventoy flash drive. I'll right click and then click on paste, and that's going to copy it to the Ventoy flash drive. Now while that's running in the background, we can go ahead and navigate back to the Ventoy flash drive, the root of the Ventoy flash drive, because here we have this templates folder, and inside of the templates folder, we're going to take our auto-unattended.xml file, and we're basically going to right-click, copy that, and then also paste it into this templates directory here. So as you can see, the ISO file is still busy copying because it's much larger than the XML file, which is our auto-unattended answer file. And one quick thing I just want to mention is don't worry if your icon looks different than mine. That is just the code editor that I use on my computer. Yours might open with Microsoft Edge, and that's perfectly fine. As long as it has this file name, which is auto-unattend.xml, it'll work, and it must have exactly that file name there. If we go over to the instructions here, and we have a look at the top, you'll see this note that I included that says the file name included on the Windows installation media must be auto-unattend.xml or else it won't execute. So just make sure that it has that exact file name. If you downloaded it from the GitHub page, it should have that exact file name. But right now, I'm just waiting for the ISO file to finish copying, and then I'll check back with you after that. I'm just going to speed that up in the video. So once you've copied the ISO file and the auto-unattended file into the templates folder, and you've got your Windows ISO inside of the Windows folder here, then we can move on to the next step. And what you need to do now is navigate back to your Ventoy folder, and then you want to open the Ventoy Plugson EXE file. So if you go ahead and double click on that, it'll also detect your USB flash drive where you have Ventoy installed. So that is my flash drive right there. Then you can click on Start, and it's going to open a new web page in your browser here. Now there's a lot of options here, but the one we're looking for is the auto install plugin here. So if we go ahead and select that, then we're going to get to the auto install plugin page. The next thing you need to do is click on add. Then you have two options here. You're going to go ahead and select the parent option, which is the second option here. Then click on OK. And then you're going to need to provide two paths. So if we go to the instructions here, you can see that we've selected parent. And now in the directory path, we need to paste the path to our ISO folder or the ISO Windows folder. And then in the template path, we're going to paste the absolute path to the auto-unattended.xml file. So let me show you how to do that. You're going to go to your Ventoy flash drive. So once you have this path here, you can click inside of the address bar up here, and then you're going to see it basically gives you the absolute path of that folder. So you can just go ahead and right click on this, then click on copy. Another thing I should mention is right now, the drive letter of my Ventoy flash drive here is F. Yours might be different, but it doesn't matter. Your path should look exactly the same as mine, but your drive letter might be something different. It might be D or it might be E. It doesn't matter. as long as you copy the entire path, then go back to the Ventoy Plugson webpage. Then you can just right-click here and you can click on paste, which will then paste the directory path. And as you can see, it also gave us an example down there, which in this case is the same that we've copied. Then for the template, we need to provide the absolute file path for the unattended file. If we go back to our Ventoy flash drive and we go to our templates folder, that's where we have the autounattend.xml file saved. Now, we can't just click in the address bar again and then just provide this path because we need to provide the full path with the autounattended file included. So you can right-click on the autounattended file here, and then you should have an option that says copy as path. If you're using the Windows 11 right-click menu, you might have to click on More Options, and then you'll find the Copy as Path option. But I'm using a program called Shell, which changes my right-click context menu, and that's why I have this File Manage option here, which gives me the option to copy the entire path, which in this case is the drive letter, the templates folder, and then the file name. So if I click on that, and I go to my Ventoy Plugson folder, and I right-click here, and I click on Paste, it pastes the absolute path to the autounattended.xml file. Now, just to show you, if you don't find a copy as path option on your right-click menu, what I suggest you do is just click on the address bar up here. Then you can go ahead and right-click and copy that file path. Then you can basically paste the file path. But what you'll need to do is you'll also need to enter a backslash, and then you can type the file name, which is autounattend.xml, because that is the file name that we have inside of our templates folder. And then that's another way of manually adding this if you don't have the option of copying the entire file path. But once you have it like this, you can click on OK. Then you'll see that the configuration has been successfully applied. And once you've done this, you can basically close this web page. I'm just going to minimize this as well. You can click on the stop button for the Ventoy Plugson. You'll receive this prompt. Just click on yes, and then you can exit. Then you can basically go ahead and close down all of these folders, and you should now have your Ventoy USB flash drive looking the same as mine. And once you have that, you're ready to go ahead and install Windows on your computer. So while the computer is starting up, I'm just going to press F12, which is the boot menu key for this motherboard. Then I'm going to go ahead and select my USB flash disk. Now you'll see for the generic USB flash disk, I've got two options that I can select. One is the UEFI option, which is selected now. And then the other one is just a generic USB flash disk, which is basically the old way of booting, which is also called the legacy BIOS. So in most cases, if you have the UEFI option, you'd want to use that. But if you have a really old computer, you'll probably just see the one option, which is the old legacy option. And in that case, you can go ahead and use that. But if you do have the UEFI option, I suggest that you select that and then press enter. Now, if you have Secure Boot enabled, you'll either have to disable it like I have, and you might have seen that message that said Secure Boot is disabled. But if you don't have it disabled, you also have the option of just enrolling the Ventoy key. And in that case, you can just press enter, and then you can follow the on-screen instructions where you just have to enroll the key from the Ventoy disk, and you can just navigate to this file that says enroll this key in Mock Manager. Then you can go ahead and select that and enroll the key so you can add Ventoy as a secure boot option. But I also have a more detailed video showing you how to do that, and I'll link that in the cards and in the video description now. But basically, once you've gotten to this Ventoy screen and you've successfully booted from the flash drive, you'll see the ISO files that you have saved on that Ventoy USB flash drive. In my case, I have the Windows 11 ISO file. So next, you just need to press enter on the keyboard, and it's going to give you the following options. Then you need to select boot in normal mode. So I'm just going to go ahead and press enter again. And then you get this option where you can either boot from this ISO file without the auto installation template, or you can boot with the auto unattended installation template. So that's the one we added. And if I go ahead and leave that selected and then press enter, it's going to start booting from that Windows 11 ISO file. And it's also going to include the auto unattended XML file in the installation media. Then once it's booted from the Windows installation media, it's basically just a normal Windows setup that you need to go through. So I'm just going to select my country and region here. Then select I don't have a product key. I'm going to select Windows 11 Pro because that's what I want to install. Then click on Next. Then I'm just going to delete all of the partitions on my SSD because there's no data that I want to save on this drive. I'm just going to wipe it completely and start with a new Windows installation. So I'll just delete all of the partitions, then select the unallocated space and click on next. And that's going to start the Windows installation. Now, once that's done, it's going to reboot and boot into the specialized phase, which is where most of the commands will be run. And then we're going to get to this onboarding experience phase. So here in the onboarding phase, you can just choose your country and region again, and then choose your keyboard layout. And I'm not going to add a secondary keyboard layout, so I'll just skip that. Then you can choose a name for your user account. In my case, I'm just going to choose memory, then click on next. I'm not going to be using a password, so I'll just leave that blank and then click on next again. It should now load into the user profile and take me to the desktop. And then once we get to the desktop, it should automatically restart again because it'll run the current user CMD script, which basically also adds a lot of registry entries to the current user. And then once it's restarted, it's going to load directly into your user profile, and then you can start using the computer. So you'll have the clean start menu here with no apps basically pre-installed because this is the core version. And like I mentioned, the Windows security is disabled by default, but the Windows security suite is still installed with the firewall and all of the other protection. It's basically just the Windows Defender part of it, which is the antivirus, that's just turned off by default. And I don't really recommend that you use this. If you're planning on using this, you should get another antivirus installed on your computer, but you still have firewall protection and account protection and all of the other stuff. That's part of the Windows security suite. So as you can see, it's getting the protection info for this device here, and it usually takes a little while before it actually displays the info. And as you can see, if we go ahead and have a look at the settings here, if we go to the virus and threat protection settings, these sliders have all been turned off and disabled by default. And as you can see, you can't turn off some of these settings. So even if I clicked on that and then clicked on yes, it just immediately disables it again. But like I said earlier, if you're planning on using the core version of the auto unattended file, which disables Windows Defender, then you'll have to get a third-party antivirus installed on your computer. But you'll still have the firewall and network protection and all of that. But that's how you can use the Ventoy auto install plugin to install Windows using an auto unattended answer file. And I hope this video was useful. If it was, please click the like button. And if you want to support the channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.